Let's continue our discussion on variables, and what we're going to do next is look at putting information into the variables. And we call that setting the variable or variable assignment. And so I'm going to create a public class variable assignment fun class, public static void main string args. And so let's go back to the example we just did. If I'm storing a building height, so I'll create another integer, call it building height. Again, that's the identifier that I'm giving to it. And let's picture what's happening when I do that. I am creating a, open up a paint window here. And so back to memory, I've gone out to memory, and I am saying, go out and reserve me 64 bits of memory to store building height. This is going to take forever. I really need to get a pen board. I know what I can do. I can pause. Voila. Okay, so building height. The question is, what is currently in that variable? And the answer is nothing. But it's worse than a zero. It's something we refer to as a null, meaning there's a lack of information in that variable. And nulls are extremely bad in programming, because if we run into a null in the course of our program, the program will crash. And so because of that, we always want there to be something in that variable. And so I can just put something in there in the beginning, and we call that initializing the variable. Okay, so this is initialization of the variable. I'm putting a zero in there so that if by chance, I'll put the zero in there, wow, that's a big zero. If by chance I hit that variable, so because before, if I didn't have that initialization in there and I tried to use that variable, system.out.println, and I want to print out the building height, I'll save this, compile it, and it tells me that variable might not have been initialized. There's nothing in there. And so it's warning you that that could cause problems in the program. And so if I go in and put in a zero to begin with, then the program runs fine. I won't run into any errors, because at the very least, it's not going to print out the right information. It might print out a zero, but it's not going to print out the right information. Or sorry, it's not going to get an error with the right information. Sorry, I messed up. There we go. So this works now, and it will print out that zero. If I run this program, it's going to print out the zero. But there's at least something in there. So the question is, what do we want to initialize the variable with? Well, that's up to you. A lot of times we'll put a default in there. But we want whatever's in there maybe not to be a legal value. Like maybe we'll put a negative 1 in there, because that can't be a real building height. We don't have, that doesn't even make sense. A height can't be negative. And so now if we run the program, and if by chance somewhere in the program it got messed up, building height didn't get set to what it was supposed to, in the beginning we'd initialized it to a negative 1, and so when we run it we'll see a negative 1 and we'll say, whoa, there's something wrong with the program. We can't have a negative number for a height. Whereas, can a height be 0? This is probably some theoretical question. Theoretically, I guess every molecule has a height, it's just really small. But anyway, so the point is, what do we want to default everything to? We want to put something in there to begin with. And so if it's an int, we might put a 0 in there. If it's a double, we might put a 0.0 in there. If it's a Boolean, then we have to either put a true or a false in there. So we have to kind of make the decision, what do we want to be in there at first? If nothing else happens in the program, what do we want the default to be? A lot of times if we create a char or a string, a char we might set the letter equal to just a blank, a space, or maybe we can make up a character that we, if a space is a valid character, maybe we need to have it be something else. With a string, a lot of times, a string sentence, we'll set it equal to just a blank, so that it's not, there's not a null in there. It's just, rather than being null, it's blank, and blank is better than null. Okay, so does that make sense? With variables that we're setting, then we'll always try to initialize them to something so that we don't run into the problem of getting an error. Okay, so back to this idea of the building height. I've got this variable set. Okay, and later on, in my program, so maybe I'm doing some other stuff and I come in and now I want to set the variable. The way that I do that is to just type building height and set it equal to what I want it to be equal to. So let's say it's 150 feet tall. It's a good sized building, right? Why didn't I have to put the int again? In fact, if I put the int again, I'm going to get an error saying it's already been defined. This int is telling Java, go out and reserve this word for me. Go out and reserve this space for me. This is like, I got home building on the mind because we've been in this, me and my wife, and this is like buying the lot. Okay, we're not going to actually put anything on it yet. We're just buying the lot. So this much here is just going out to memory and saying, reserve me a space. Don't put anything in it yet. So pretend that zero is not there. Then, after we have reserved the word, it's already done. We don't have to do anything else. Then we can go out and say, remember that spot that I reserved in memory? Now go set it to 150, but I don't need to redeclare it. Let me reinitialize that variable. So now we've got initialization there, and this is just assigning the variable. This is setting it. In Java, what we're assigning goes on the left, and what we are assigning it to goes on the right. So the left is where we're assigning it, and then the right is the information that we are assigning to that variable. So we're saying go out to that building height and put 150 in there, and when we execute this line, now it's going to be 150 that's sitting out in memory. Okay? Making sense so far? Well, so what happens then if I try? So this will run and should print out just fine. So I get my 150 printed out because that is now what's sitting out in that variable. Okay, so what happens though if I get a height like 150.5? Well, we already know that that's not going to work because 150.5 is a decimal number, a floating point number. And this is set up for an integer. Well, that's a problem. We run into this problem sometimes where we need to store this information in building height, but the information that's coming in is an integer. And so this brings up the idea of casting. Java allows us to convert one type to another type by casting. And the way that we do that is to take, and in parentheses, before it, whatever it is we're trying to cast, we put the type of information we want it to be. So I'm saying int in parentheses, and then after it comes the type of information I'm trying to cast. When I do this, the error goes away, because what it's going to do is it's going to take and take this information and make it into an integer. And then it's going to store that information in the integer type variable. Again, this way, error. This way, no error. Now the question is, at 150.5, that should technically round up to 151. What's it going to do when we cast this? Let's take a look and see. So I compile it, I run it, and notice what it prints out. It prints out 150. Let's try 150.9 just to make it more definite. This should definitely be 151, yet what's printed out is 150. Because what casting does is it takes the integer portion, and that's the part that it puts into the variable. This portion is just stripped off. And so casting is definitely not a perfect solution, but we can cast. From one type that we need to another type that we need in that situation. And again, casting, we just do that by an integer. If I wanted to force this to be a double, then I'd put double in the parentheses. If I wanted to force this to be a char, then I'd put char in the parentheses. That wouldn't, I mean, we're going to get an error if we try and do that. No, we aren't. Chars are kind of funny. We'll talk about those more in detail later, because 150 actually represents a character in the ASCII chart. And so I shouldn't have done that example there. But the point is, we can cast from one type to another, right? So I can force this double type information, 150.9, to being an integer by putting that int out in front, and that casts that number as an integer. That's called casting. Okay. Well, what would have happened if I had declared this as a double in the first place, and then I try and put an integer into it? What's going to happen now? Because this isn't 150.0, this is 150. This is an integer type that I'm trying to store in a double type variable. I run it, and no problem at all. An integer can fit in a double. A double can't fit in an integer. It's kind of like, the way I look at it is, my little 2-year-old daughter likes to play with this little, it's like a mixer she has, and she takes, and it's got different shapes, and so you're supposed to put the circle piece through the circle hole and the square piece through the square hole and whatnot. Well, if you had a circle and a square, you could take and put the circle through the square hole, right? Because it's just, if they were the same size, because it has no corners, you could just fit it through the middle, right? That's kind of like an integer going into a double. And on the other hand, a double going into the integer, that won't work because of the corners, right? The double is bigger. The double is 64 bits. A floating point number, the integer is 32 bits, so we can't take the 64-bit number and put it into the 32-bit slot. But on the other hand, we can take that 32-bit integer and fit it into a double, and all it does is put a .0 at the end. All right, so I think that's about it for assignment. We just need to remember this principle of casting. And by the way, I can cast this. I can still cast that 150 to be a double, but it automatically does it as part of that process to get to that 150.0 when we put it in the double variable. All right. And that kind of concludes our discussion on variables. We'll use them a lot more, but those are all the kind of basics about variables. All right. Spencer out.